Hi, welcome to this vid tip for Penny Abernathy's Leadership in Digital Media Economics class. This one is on doing company and industry research. And what I'm going to do is focus on the library course page that I've created, and we're going to look at one database in detail. You are going to need to look at all of the resources on this page, but I'm going to focus on NetAdvantage, and hopefully that will give you some ideas about how to proceed in searching the other databases. So, as I say, we're going to focus on NetAdvantage. And my best tip to be really efficient is to search by ticker symbol. And you can see here, get the cursor over here, that I've done ticker equals Disney. And so here's some information about Disney. And over on the right, you see a whole bunch of information that you can get about Disney. So you'll definitely want to look through all of these for your company. This is the overview. And I strongly recommend also that you look at the stock reports. That's what we're going to look at now. And you'll see here, this is a stock report. It's dated January 12th. Today is January 15th, so you can see how current this information is. This is a PDF that I've downloaded. You can look at it online or you can look at it as a PDF. And you'll notice that the PDF is 10 pages. So it's pretty substantial information. Another thing you'll want to look at in the stock report is the Wall Street consensus. When you're looking at it online, you get a bunch of some hyperlinks over on the right-hand side, and if you click on Wall Street consensus, you will see analyst recommendations. You get this error message. I can't get the error message to go away, so I don't know what you'd get if you didn't have the error message, but what you do get is the number of analysts that are following this company. You get what they say about buy, hold, weak hold, and sell, and then you get more information over here. And that's definitely something that you're going to need for class. Another thing to look at when you're at the main page for the company is how to analyze, where again you'll get more analyst recommendation, which is definitely something that you need. So this is clicking on how to analyze. This is, I did this screenshot a year ago, and a year ago it was a strong buy. You get four options over here: company value, peer comparison, risk assessment, and company news. You can also get there by going over here. And here on this screen, I'm showing you each of the different options. Company value, what their conclusion is, what's the company worth compared to its peers, their conclusion, what are the risks for the company, and company news. And when you click on all of these, you get this summary, but you also get in the middle of the page even more information. So it's really, really useful. This how to analyze is very, very useful. Another thing that's useful is the Compustat Excel Analytics. So it defaults to giving you a company profile here, which goes on for several screens. You also get a whole bunch of reports here. These are all available as Excel files. And I downloaded the quarterly balance sheet. And so here's a screenshot of the quarterly balance sheet. And you can see September 2012, June 2012, March, and so on. I downloaded this in early January. So this is relatively current. And you can see all the data that you get. The spreadsheet goes on for screens. More and more screens. So you get some really good historic data, a lot of financial information that you'll need. Another thing that you get in NetAdvantage, and the reason it's my favorite business database, is that not only do you get the company information, you also get industry surveys. So for example, here I'm looking at the broadcasting, cable, and satellite industry, and what you get is current environment, industry profile, industry trends, key ratios, how to analyze a particular company, a glossary of terms specific to that industry, and then comparative company data. There are two ways to find industry surveys. One is by typing the company name or the ticker symbol here, and that way it'll pull up the relevant industry survey for your industry, or you can browse all of the industry surveys that are available in NetAdvantage. This is a really, really wonderful resource. And if you, you can look at it as an HTML, which I've done here. You can also download it as a PDF. And in this case, it's 44 pages for the broadcasting and cable industry. So you get a ton of information. And again, you can see here, it's the same information that we were looking at online, only it's a little more easy to read as a PDF. And these reports come out every 6 months. So you can see that this report came out in August of 2012. So a new one should be coming out, I'd guess, probably in February. So you may want to, this is your industry, you may want to keep an eye out for that. So that's a very quick overview of NetAdvantage. I strongly recommend that you look through the rest of the resources on here. Hoovers Online is the same Hoovers that you could get if you did a Google search, but all the reports are free. This is paid for by the library, so you have access to all of this material. This is particularly good if you're looking for private companies, but it's got, obviously it's got amazing detail for public companies as well. Orbis has great information on companies. If you want to do some industry research, IBIS World has great information. Just a little word of warning, IBIS World says it has company research, but we haven't paid for that. So all you get from IBIS World, which is quite a bit, is their industry research. Thomson One is amazing, has really wonderful data. It works best. This little I is a tip for a tech note, which means that in this case, you really need to use Internet Explorer for Thomson One, which is its only downside because it also has amazing data. More reports, statistics on industries and companies from Frost and Sullivan and Euromonitor's Global Market Information Database, sometimes called GMID or sometimes written out GMID. So you'll definitely need to explore all of these. I will be doing another vid tip on the Bloomberg terminal. If there's any way you can get to the Park Library or another place that has a Bloomberg terminal, that is also going to be very, very useful for doing company and industry research. But these are essential, so you definitely need to be familiar with these. If you have any questions after watching this vid tip, please get in touch with me. You know how. I'd be happy to help you. This is one of my favorite things to research is company and industry because these databases are amazing. So happy searching, good luck, and thanks for watching this vid tip.